Hi, this is a video on calculating the standard deviation. It's a little bit longer calculation, so that's why it gets its own special video. And if you need this worksheet, you can get it on my website at caralemath.com. And we're talking about, just to put us in context here, we're talking about how to describe data. And there's four things we need to describe: shape, center and spread, and outliers or unusual features. So this is one of the measures of spread, standard deviation. So you could think of it as the average deviation from the mean. It's how far away are the people or the subjects, how far away are they on average from the mean? We can approximate it by the range divided by 4 if the data is evenly spread without any outliers. So we're going to do it both ways. We're going to calculate the actual standard deviation, and we'll calculate the approximation and see how they compare. Now we have the same data set we've been using, which is the test scores from a Math 95 test, fictitious, of course. So here's the formula. Now it might look a little daunting, but I'm going to show you how this works. And once you learn how to read it, and then the procedure, it'll be no problem, I'm sure. Okay, so here's our data, and I have all the numbers on the left-hand side here. We're gonna start on the very inside here. So what this says is X, that is our data values. We're gonna use the letter X to represent that. We're gonna subtract the mean, and then we're gonna square it. So we're gonna find the deviation. How far away is each person from the mean? All right, we need to know our mean. So let's write our mean. We calculated that in a different video. And it was 72.6. You know what, we're gonna make it 73 to make our life a little easier on this video. Often we'll use software, Excel, or another software to do this anyway, so we'll be nice to ourselves, and we'll subtract 73 from every single value. That's going to give us our deviation from the mean. You might be saying, why did you give us 19 data values? Okay, so we're going to subtract 73 from all these. Look at, this one's gonna be negative, right? Because we're subtracting a bigger thing. So this is negative 24. This is also negative 24. Negative 21. Negative 15. Looks like 9. Oh, sorry, 11. That's why I'm using a calculator. Subtraction is not my favorite. Negative 6. That's negative 2. That's 0. We actually have someone right on the mean of 73. This is going to be 1. This is going to be 2. It's going to be 5, 8, it's going to be 9, because I'm just adding 1, 11, 12, 13, let's move it up. 18 and 23. Okay, so we have our deviations. Makes sense because they're in order that the two ends will have higher deviations, right? Some are negative and some are positive. Now, if we were to add all these deviations up, we'd have a problem. We would actually end up with 0 because the average is the average. If we subtract the average from everything, we're going to get 0. So that doesn't work for a measure. So what we're actually going to do is square all of these numbers. So we're going to take negative 24 and square it. And remember, it's the same as squaring 24. 576. Or if you really want to put the negative, remember you need parentheses so that doing too many things at once. 24 squared, 576. Remember that you would need parentheses to indicate that it's negative 24 times negative 24. Okay, so this one will also be 576. This one will be negative 21 squared. 441. Those are big. 15 squared is 225. You can drop the negatives if you want to, because we know it's going to be positive. 11 squared is 121. 7 squared is 49. 6 squared is 36. 2 squared is 4. 0 squared is 0. 1 squared is 1. 2 squared is 4. 5 squared is 25. 8 squared is 64, right? Yes, I knew that. 9 squared is 81. 11 squared is 121. 12 squared is 144. 13 squared is 169. Did you know that one? 18 squared, I don't know that one. 324. And 23 squared, 529. Okay, those are some big numbers because we have a lot of deviation. We've got 23 away from the mean on this side and 24 away from the mean on this side. Okay, so let's look at what we've done in terms of our formula so far. Starting on the inside, we took our value, our data value, our x, subtracted the mean, and then we squared each one of those. Now this is a capital sigma. What that means is sum. It means add all those together. So we add all those together. We need to total this column here, and we'll write that in here, the sum of the squared deviations, and then I have the formula down here also. So let's add all these up. It'll take a minute. The zero. Oh, I have a typo on the very last one. 529. Okay, double check me. I got 3,490. Okay, can't really put units on here because we've just squared everything. So this number would be in terms of points squared, but that doesn't really mean anything. So let's keep going with our formula. We've got the deviations squared and we summed all those up. Next thing we need to do is subtract by n minus 1. N is the number of data points you have. Number of data values. Okay, so let's go ahead and write this out. So S stands for standard deviation. We're going to take the square root of 3,490 divided by We had 19, and we're going to go one less. So it's going to be 18. So we had 19 data values. We subtract 1. And so let's put this in the calculator. I'll put it over here. Let's get the glare off of it. Okay. Square root, I'm going to punch it in all at the same time. 3490 divided by 18 equals 13.92. Now we can do points. So what happened was we squared all the deviations so that they didn't cancel each other out. But then, in order to get back to our original units, we had to take the square root. So see how we kind of averaged the deviation? We took the squares of the deviations, we added them up, we divided by 18, though, instead of 19. So it's kind of an average. It turns out that this is a better estimator than if you actually divided by 19. So we use one less. And then we take the square root, so we get from squared points back to points. And our standard deviation always has the same units as the data that we have. Okay, so we've got our standard deviation. That's, we're using letter S for a sample standard deviation. And now I want to see how this range divided by 4 estimate works. How close is that going to be? It says that you can use the range divided by 4 if the data is evenly spread without outliers. So let's remember our data. Was it evenly spread without outliers? Kind of. The mean and the median were fairly close, and so it's a little bit skewed. So let's see. Our range was, what? Our range was 47 points. So if we do the range divided by 4, 47 divided by 4, how does that come out? 11.75. Okay, so it came out under, but based on all of this work, maybe it's worth it to do the range divided by 4. However, in real life, when you're doing data analysis, you'll be using Excel or another computer software package, so it will calculate that for you. It's good to go through it a few times, though, so that you really understand what the standard deviation means. So you can really see how we're finding the deviation, squaring it, adding them up, and then dividing by n minus 1, then we're taking the square root to get back to the original units. Okay, so that is the standard deviation. We'll also be talking a lot more about standard deviation when we get to the normal distribution. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video or in class.